for women to take a quiet move. You would realize the master didn't do anything to anybody that he didn't do for you. You were in the marketplace, you may have been there early, and I came at 5 o'clock, but we were both in the marketplace. Nobody had us but the master. Oh, glory to God. But the master interrupted my idleness and sent me to work in his land. I'm glad to be in the employ of the Lord. So here is the final challenge for the church: to reflect, to mirror the generosity of God. To reflect, to mirror the generosity of God. And share with God's people with that I will have no savings account. No banking in the Bahamas. In fact, I have no savings account in no bank in the world. Because I got a giving away demon. The minute I see somebody in need, my bubbles of compassion, they are restless until I minister to that need. Reverend Smith, so you are a young minister trying to get ahead in life. Reverend Smith, you are a young minister trying to get ahead in life. Let me see this old preacher and give you a piece of advice. Don't shut up your bowels of compassion because you're trying to get over in life. Be a blessing as God blessed you. And I am a living witness that he would open up the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing that you ain't got good enough to receive. And I'm a living witness that everything I need, the Lord supplies. And just in the nick of time, the Lord sends help from his holy habitation because I endeavor to reflect the generosity of God. That's gone for the 6 months of COVID. This church kept its employees and staff at full salary because the church got to take the lead and show the world that you cannot treat people the way the world treats them when their backs are against the wall and there are times when it hurts. But we made up in our mind that if God be God, then our workers must know that the love of God is inside of this fellowship. And every person that came knocking on the door asking for help, we did it by the power of the living God, because the church was the flat, the generosity of God. And stop crying, poor boy, like the world. Trust in the Lord with all thy heart and lean not to thine own understanding. The Lord is a waymaker. David said it right. I've been young and now I'm old, and I've never seen the righteous forsaken, nor their seed begging bread. The Lord is able. Generosity of God. We are reminded to prioritize the vulnerable. We must revisit the disruptive element of grace. We must rebuke spiritual arrogance and that sense of entitlement. Must mirror the generosity of God. If I had a sermon topic, the sermon topic would have been stop crumbling at grace. Stop crumbling at grace. If I had a sermon topic, it would have been stop crumbling at grace. What God is doing in the lives of others is not an occasion for you to grumble, but rather it is an occasion, Brother Eric, for you to lift your hands and tell the Lord thank you that he knows. church is called to visit this disruptive element of grace. The church is called to rebuke spiritual arrogance in the sense of entitlement. But perhaps the church is called to reflect in mirror the generosity of God. And someone who gave me my hands to reach out to man, to show him your love and your perfect plan. You gave me my hands. Because we now have responsibility before the Lamb of God to act like people in His employ. Your eyes are closed. Your heart stays there before the Lord. As the psalmists minister, if you want to make yourself available to God, just step out of your seat. Come to the altar, maintain your distance, but we as Baptists believe that the altar is the place of succor. Because God wants to use you.
I just want to be.
about the resurrected Christ, who is seated on the right hand of the Father, the just judge. He is going to pay us according as our work will be. So help us not to stop in our right hand. Help us not to become weary and well doing. For in due season, we shall faint. We will reap rather if we faint not. Oh God, we pray for the Christian church in the Bahamas that seems off course and oblivious to its backstabbing membership. Pray the church member to prioritize the vulnerable. May the church in the Bahamas revisit the disruptive element of grace. May the church in the Bahamas rebuke spiritual arrogance and the sense of entitlement. Please, sir, may the church in the Bahamas reflect and mirror the generosity of our Lord. We say thank you. Oh God, we say thank you. We say thank you. Thank you, God. Thank you. If I walk in the pathway of duty, if I learn to the close of the day, I shall see the great King.